Hi, my name is Miguel Kuh. I am a PhD student at Vanderbilt University. I am so happy to be here at the colloquium. I want to talk a little bit about my research, which focuses on cultural implications for nutritional guidelines in Guatemala in Quiché Maya population. So Guatemala is a multicultural country in Central America, but also Guatemala has a huge problem that is the chronic malnutrition. Chronic malnutrition refers to that the children under 5 years old don't grow very well. We have a national average of 50% of children under 5 years old have chronic malnutrition. So if we see this picture, the child in the right has 105 centimeters of height. If we see the child in the left, he has 84 centimeters of height. That means that he does growing up very well. So he has chronic malnutrition. So Guatemala is a multicultural country with two main populations, the Maya population and the non-Maya population. Around 41% of people in Guatemala is Maya, and we have 22 Maya communities. I focus in the big population that is the Quiché Maya population. If we see the map in the corner left, we see a map with red color. This area is the area where the chronic malnutrition in children is the highest. Around in these communities have 8 of 10 children under 5 years old with chronic malnutrition. And this area is the same area where the majority of Maya population lives. So one strategy to approach the chronic malnutrition from the Minister of Health of Guatemala is the Guatemala Food Guidelines. It's a guidelines to promote healthy and nutritional food to all the people in Guatemala, to all the population. Like US has nutritional guidelines too, based on food, like the food pyramid and my plate. So this is a guidelines that based on biomedicine knowledge that focus on specific nutrition issues. For example, they understand food through the lens of nutritional that focus on carbohydrates, fat, protein, vitamins, and minerals, only chemical issues. But in Maya communities in Guatemala, food serves as more than a nutritional substance. Food is also the cornerstone of religious, cultural, and social lives. So my research focuses in understand the Quiché Maya food categories and compare these ones with the Guatemala food guidelines with regards to lenguas pragmatic. That means that the context of the communities gives meaning to the food. And cultural models, that means that the organization, hierarchical and structural of indigenous knowledge and language provides meaning to the food groups. So for example, we have shapes in the right, and these shapes we could organize and categorize in triangles or in based on colors like yellow. So that is example how we could give meanings to the objects like food. So I have worked in the last 3 years in the Quiché Highlands of Guatemala to iterate data through surveys, qualitative food diet records, in-depth interviews, and participatory observation. So essentially, I have some data that refers that the Quiché Maya population have different food groups that is different from the Guatemala food guidelines. For example, Quiché Maya groups have two main categories: wa, solid food, and then ha, drink food or liquid food. And then we have two subcategories: that is a wa, that is corn-based food like tortillas, tamales, etc., and requil, that is side food for the main group, that is core-based food. So essentially, the Kichimaya population have two groups, wa and ha, solid food and drink. And then we have two subcategories under wa. The wa, that is corn-based food, and then the sides, the food that is aside for the corn-based food. And then we have riquil and racit, that is like other kinds of food that is aside for the for a corn-based food. So that means that we have different groups in the Kichimaya context and the Kichimaya language that is different to the nutritional guidelines. So the challenge here is like the nutritional and food guidelines in Guatemala is for all the population. That means that they approach in Spanish. They don't think in Maya communities, for example, how much these two groups, the Kichimaya groups and the Guatemalan food guidelines, to promote a better healthy food patterns for the Kichimaya population. Because as we see previously, the nutritional guidelines based on chemistry and biology issues, and the Kichimaya food groups focus on the language and the corn-based food. So this thing have implication, how could understand nutritional and cultural issues to improve the nutritional status in Maya families in Guatemala with a huge problem like the chronic malnutrition. So another thing is like the indigenous language matter. The meaning of the food based on the language issues could provide a better approach to improve the nutritional and food guidelines to all the population, not only the Maya population, the Maya population too. And these have global implications too, because in Latin America, we have a huge group of indigenous people like Quechuas and Mapuches. So for example, we need to understand this kind of language and cultural issues in this context to provide a better health and nutrition guidelines in all the population in Latin America. So this is my presentation. Thank you very much.